Good morning. It's raining. It's cold. I'm gonna go to my wrap appointment. Hadar was so nice to put my bandages already in the car. I'm gonna go early, and she's gonna use a machine on me that basically they use in the hospital to keep your fluid moving. It pumps up and down, feels really good. It's like a little massage. So I'm gonna use that for an hour before my appointment. So I'm gonna wrap for an hour. This is for lipedema, in case you're just now watching. I'm getting treated for lipedema. And I'm in stage 3 right now. It's a progressive disorder, so I don't want to hit stage 4. Stage 4 isn't too good for me, so we're trying to halt the progress of the disease, basically. Anyway, I gotta take my medicine because I'm out of breath. I got a lot done. I want to show you when I get home all the stuff that I cleaned yesterday. I'm very happy with my house right now. And here's my bandages. And this is my medicine. This one probably is on E, but I got this in Europe. Basically, I got it in Israel. And this is the only one that like works for me, but it is on E. This, when you inhale it, it goes into your lungs and I'm good to go. Well, the other one, it's a puffer. It's the same medicine, it's just the application is different. It's a puffer and it doesn't go all the way in my lungs because I can't breathe that deep. But I, with this, I can continuously breathe it in. It's got some, probably like the powder left. It still works for me even though it's on E. That's how good that medicine is. So even if you have universal health care, everybody says universal health care, oh, it's socialism. It really isn't. You pay a lot of taxes, but you don't see a lot of the work going into your taxes unless you live in a really good place with really good schools and really good roads. You don't see a lot of your tax dollars. But with universal health care, it was super great. Honestly, the wait times were extensive, and if they didn't have doctors, that was it. You didn't get to see a doctor. And that happened to us several times with my breathing and with Raphael's autism and his therapies. So anyway, I'm gonna go up in here. Every time I go and talk to her, it's like having a girlfriend to talk to. She talks about everything. Nothing is off limits. It's like therapy. Basically, even though it's massage therapy and treatment, it's therapy for me, for my brain, to get to talk to somebody. And yeah, it's helpful, that one-on-one talking.
Lymphopress. Okay, this one's too big. Size 3, 65 length. So 5 foot tall, and then it comes up to here. So this one's good for me, fits good. This leg is bigger.
This leg is bigger
by like 3 inches.
Oh, this goes so good.
All right, he's fixing the door.
Really,
because
loud.
It's hard to open. Yeah, it's loud. I'm home though. Welcome back for me.
Please hold.
Caller number 21. I'm trying to call my EDS doctor. He is extremely popular because he's probably the only one that they have in the state of Florida, I think. I don't know.
Please hold for the next available representative. Or you may press 1.
Finally, so I got my appointment set up really good. I haven't been seeing him because basically the way my knees were getting where I was disabled, basically, and not to walk, but to like get up and down, to sit on a toilet, to sit on a couch, to get up. It was basically, I couldn't do it without a lot of pain, a lot of pain. When I say I'm in pain, that's already past like 90% of people's threshold. So, it was basically making me worse. So I'm going to talk to him about, just doing my neck and not touching my legs and my knees, because my neck's been needing some things. He really does something with the neck that just stretches it and makes it feel like I have more like two inch longer neck is what he makes it feel like. So we were able to cut up some peppers. I'm going to make some sausage with, my aunt used to make this all the time. I don't have potatoes. I don't want to use sweet potatoes, I think. I like the sweet potatoes to not be in, like, a more savory dish.
Pot?
Even though I make the sweet potatoes savory, I don't think this would be good with that. I don't know. So, sausage and a few peppers, onions, and cabbage is what we're going to have in the hot instant pot. And then back here, we're going to have some fried onions and peppers just to keep for, like, eggs and stuff, right?
Yeah, I'm telling her no because she wants to eat that.
And, well, she can eat the colored parts of it. I cut it a little bit.
You trust Abigail to make a difference between the two?
Well, no, because she eats the entire core of an apple. When she eats an apple, she eats the entire thing. Which is fine, because you wouldn't be able to eat enough arsenic to hurt you from the apple seeds. But she does like a whole apple. You know who else likes whole apples? Unicorns.
Yummy.
Apple. So I have a question for Rhiannon. In Ohio, my mom used to call these mangoes. Do you call them mangoes or do your family call them mangoes? My mom had a difficult time finding bell peppers one time and she's like, where's your mangoes? And they pointed her to the mangoes. Yeah, she asked for mangoes and she got mangoes. That was a fruit. And she was shocked. She says, what are these? And then she figured out that different parts of the country call things different things. And that was very strange. So I'm going to cook these up. Oh, I love onions and bell peppers together. I could eat this by itself. I'm going to cook it up. Probably put it in some eggs later. And we got our sausages, yummy sausages. So it's gonna go in here with a little water and cooked.
So you may have seen me earlier fixing the door, and that's not really fixing, it's just maintenance, but having Rudy next to the door down there, made a lot of hair go into the track. Without replacing the rollers for a 30 or nearly 40 year old door, basically, that's as smooth as it'll go. And I'm not using a whole lot of force on it. Right? Can you do that? Can you shut it? There we go, and she learned a technique to shut it, but you have to be stable when you do that. There we go. Very good. Because more annoying than doing maintenance like that, taking everything off and cleaning it and lubing it, more annoying is cleaning fingerprints off of here. And they're very visible at night. You can already see them. Now, as far as Rudy goes, I don't know. We'll see if we can get a different spot for her. Maybe she'll be here for a while longer, but this can't happen. Look how clean it is, and you guys have seen videos before. And basically why I chose to do that today is because Rudy had a mishap yesterday and she puked in the rail. So I cleaned it up and that was okay, but I was like, okay, well, I'm gonna go clean it up in the morning because it happened at, like, I don't know, 11 p.m. Right before I went to bed, I went to tell her goodnight, petted her, and I saw just a puddle of, all that throw up. So, decided to clean it, and then I was like, this is really hard to move anyway, so why not just, it's a nice day outside, do the maintenance, get it done with. It's not gonna be any better than this with these rollers, and the rollers are, they're hard stuck in there. And to get the rollers out, I would need a lot of PB Blaster. Like, I'd have to put a lot of force and hope that I don't break anything in doing that, just to get the roller out, and then go to the store and hope that they have that model, because older doors like this have different models for the rollers. But that's basically what I did. I put the door sideways over there and cleaned it very thoroughly for a very long time. And then I cleaned the rail as well. I lubed the rollers and everything attached to them, and the lock too, actually, the locking mechanism. And yeah, hopefully I never have to do this again, but realistically, probably next year, one more time. The next very epic ordeal we have is basically all of this needs to make this a nice place to be. And obviously we put those there tentative, just basically threw them there, you know, just so we can have a nice place to walk, and it has helped tremendously, but it doesn't look good. And so we're probably gonna do that project as soon as we have a nice lit day and it's not very cold. Like right now it's perfect weather, it's probably about 50 or 60, I love it. I can't believe I do without this weather pretty much 80-90% of the time, but it is what it is. And I'm just walking here and having fun, actually, just talking to you guys. Now, Andrea asked me why I was raking yesterday some more, and that's why. It's because a lot of the grass here is dead, and I wanted to clear it out so much so that it'll start growing again. And you guys can see the difference between this and this over here. But it basically made it look much neater and nicer. Now, all these blocks, I'm probably gonna make a paveway right here as well, so we can walk the pressure washer and ourselves to that water hose. So to open the valve, we have to get here. And this is usually, when it rains, this is what happens, right? I mean, it sprays mud everywhere, and pretty much, see how this, that was covered? Pretty much, if you guys remember, all of them were covered, and I had to uncover them from all the goop that accumulated over a long time. It's extremely humid here. It doesn't look like it, but I've been here a few times, right? In Florida, I've never experienced as bad a humidity as I did this year. And for a long time in the year too, like months. Months of just rain and humidity, and you walk outside and it's hot and sweaty and it's raining and it's just impossible. So moss grows here like I haven't seen anywhere else. It's crazy. But at least it's coming together. Like, I actually enjoy being out here. It's very peaceful. I acquire peace through not having items lying around. So don't regard that, because that has to be dealt with. But just coming here and having a clear pathway and it looks good and there's just nothing here, like minimal, that's my style. And inside the house, Andrea has pretty much done organizing things that we don't need. Now, the entire time I was out there with the windows, we had Kitty. Unfortunately, Kitty has a tendency to go escape right away. She just bolts through the door, so I had to keep her in here. And Abigail, you can get your dollies. Bless you, Kitty. It's time to get out.
Okay.
Yeah, when you have less things, it's just, look how nice. It's neat. Nothing in between. Just as messy as it'll get is a basket right there. Like, they're playing and I have my stuff here and it looks 10 times better than they did last week.
Dear family, the king of our country wanted us to find a route through the New World to the Pacific Ocean. The European countries wanted to trade with Asia, so we traveled to Asia, but it was a dangerous traveling, trying to think about it.
Okay, go ahead. One of the very incredible things about vlogging is that you can see progress, right? So I'll never see this rail this clean again. And I'll think it's clean in 3 months, and then I'll film it and go back to this vlog and I'll see it and I'll be like, oh, what the heck? How did it get so dirty? Now, what's this meal called?
Sausage and cabbage?
I don't know. You made it since we were in Israel.
Yeah, but it's supposed to have potatoes in it, but I just...
Yeah, I thought there was a name to it.
And my sausage, like... Oof. Blew up.
You want to wait for your brother? Food's done, Raphael. Anyway. Food's ready.
These clothes are super good.
You know what I use it for?
What?
I used them to open a jar that I couldn't because I kept slipping. So I put two of those on, and they're grippy, so.
That sausage is very, like, kielbasa-like.
All right, see how Raphael scooted out of here? He knows what to do.
Gotta wash his hands.
Man, glad I kept the camera on. It's okay. Are you alright?
Yeah.
This is, I don't know, probably 50 years old or something.
I used to be able to put my hand in there.
Can I have it?
This is for the dog. It is a dog treat, okay? So it's for Rudy. You can give it to Rudy.
It's chocolate.
Where? No, it's not.
Rudy!
Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Oh, there it is!